Hello, and welcome to Game With Us. I hope your morning, afternoon, and evening is finding you well. Today we're going to be playing some Don't Starve. They just released a new patch yesterday. Oh, got some echoing. Let me turn that off.
The ham patch.
The ham patch. Yes, well, every patch is the ham patch, technically. But yes, they did. They released a new patch.
Ham patch.
Some free items for TF2 people yesterday. The ham weapon, which of course Apocryphile is extremely excited about. So in case you don't know who we are, I'm Lockiver, and this is Apocryphile. And we are hanging out, and we're going to check out the new patch and see if I can actually see any of the new items that they added. Apparently it's the rain patch. I still haven't even seen winter, but I don't play this game that much, so we'll have to see how far we can get. I still have a lot of characters to unlock too, so...
And you just unlock them through XP.
Yeah, when you die, you get XP.
How many more do you need?
I need, I think, three more.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, last time I played, I unlocked Wolfgang.
Cool.
And then I've got three more. Looks like the robot, the librarian, and the mime are left.
What about the ham?
Ham is not a character. Don't give them that idea. They're very ham-centric as it is. As you can see here at the start.
I would buy this game if I could play a ham. I already own it, but I would buy it again if I could play a ham.
Yeah, you've never actually played this game. No, you've just watched me a little bit.
Ham.
So, I like playing Willow, the fire starter, because if I happen to be walking around out in the wilderness and it becomes dark, she just lights a fire and things don't attack her, so it's kind of fun for me to light forests on fire and grass and my camp and everything else on fire. I don't have aspirations of making it to some sort of 80-day played game. As this game has gone on and they've patched it, it keeps getting harder and harder, and so I'm less likely to get further and further. But maybe that's the point, that they're making it more challenging. I like a challenge, but once I unlock the characters, I don't know what my goal is going to be. This is a sandbox game. They're going to be adding an adventure mode as well. There's one in there to test, but it's not very complete, so I'm not going to be messing with that. But as far as goals right now, it's very sandbox. Apocryphile wouldn't have a clue what to do with it.
Uh-uh.
No. Surviving.
I don't have a clue about anything.
It would be funny if you were playing this on your computer and dying horribly as well. But anyway, so let's start up with Willow. My...
Horribly in every game I play.
You would die horribly in this game, that's for sure. I die horribly in this game, usually to hounds.
Yeah, but you're good at... Like these, is this a roguelike kind of?
Yeah, sort of. It's
a sandbox roguelike?
It's more of a sandbox. It has some roguelike elements because the maps that generate are random and the placement of items are random, but it's not roguelike in the sense that the items are unidentified. Basically, all the items do the same thing all the time, so it's got elements, but it's not, technically, it's not a real roguelike. How long will you survive? Well, so far,
that's
my record is 27 days, which is fairly horrible, but decent. I would say average. Average. And last time I played, I made it to 19 days twice. So, I don't know if I'm going to do any better than that. I don't care, quite honestly. I'm looking to see what some of the new items are. So, let's see what we can discover here. I thought my game was going to lock up for a second. So the first aspect of this game is gathering all the things.
All the things.
How's the sound, Apocryphile? Can you hear me getting the stuff? Is it too loud?
Sounds good.
Okay. That music screen is...
it's pretty... It's not annoyingly loud, that little peep.
Okay. Because, you know, I could turn it down in Windows some more, but I have it at the lowest setting in the actual game. So It's so touchy.
That's good.
Okay. The peep.
It is a peep.
Yes. I will pick some flowers. One of the first things I usually try to do is make a flower hat so that I don't lose so much sanity. And at some point, I need to experiment with insanity a little bit more. Because I missed that bush.
Because everybody needs to experiment with insanity.
Yeah, well, apparently weird things happen when you're insane. I've seen the shadow creatures, but I've never gone so insane that they start attacking me. I've just seen them, and apparently they drop items, and you can make things with the items. Nice. I don't have a lot of experience with the shadow. Basically, I've just been trying to learn how to survive and kill the enemies and stuff that come. And
acquire ham.
Yes, and I haven't really acquired any ham. I have killed the pigmen in previous patches. They drop ham. But see, they're your friends too, so it's a bit of a moral...
Oh, the moral dilemma.
Moral dilemma.
To have ham and to be friends with ham.
So what do you do, you know? Do you keep
you
your friend?
Do you have the ham? Or do you be friends with the ham?
Well...
Do you have the ham to eat, or do you have the ham to dance with?
Well, the ham can protect you in this game, too, if you don't kill them. No turkey! Oh my god, this turkey just ate my berries. Stupid bird.
Ham?
Yeah, I don't have a weapon yet. Let me see if I can make one. I can make an axe. I found one flint. I might have to... It didn't eat my ham, it ate my berries. Still unforgivable, though.
If I was a turkey, I would eat your ham.
Yeah, I know you would. I'm killing him, and I'm taking the drumstick. Killing him for eating my berries. Normally, I would just ignore him and say, stupid, stupid turkey, and completely ignore him.
Stupid, stupid turkey.
But this time, it's unforgivable. He ate my berries. That's it. It's all over.
It's unforgivable offense.
Transgression.
I declare war on you, turkey.
Yeah. Well, let's see. First day, what have I gathered? Not much. A morsel and a drumstick. I guess the turkey must have dropped a morsel too when I killed it. Because I don't think I've killed any small animals yet. This game is so violent. Survival. Eat or be eaten. What in the world is this? Examine blue mushroom. Looks like they added mushrooms in the last patch. Oh, for crying out loud. Let's go ahead and get this little tree since I started chopping it. Tree, I chop you. This forest is full of blue mushrooms that aren't actually sprouted. I wonder why they're not sprouted.
Blue mushroom, right?
I don't know. They just added mushrooms. These weren't in the patch before. I don't even know what they do.
They make you hallucinate.
They're probably not good for you, but it's really odd. There's
sanity.
There's like a whole forest of them here, and they're all like not sprouted. I wonder why. Blue mushrooms. Maybe they only sprout at night? I don't know.
How long does it take a
mushroom? Oh my god, what are those things? Oh my god, what are those? They're like... That's new.
What is that?
I don't know. I think it's those the new things they added in the patch. I don't know. There's a picture of something that kind of looked like a fish or like a merman or something. I don't know. I'm not sure. But my only option was attack. It wasn't like the pigmen. They were hanging out at a pigman house.
I would punch them.
Yeah, I don't have any armor. It might not be smart of me to do it right now. In fact, I'm gonna hang around these trees and let Willow burn them down tonight, I think. The ones that I don't chop. And then, after I do that, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I need to find a base, so I'm sort of exploring. Good place to put a base. I see there's some spider nests up here, so...
No one likes a spider nest.
No, not really. I sort of need to get some silk. It's kind of a dangerous spot to be when it's kind of dark, because I'm right on the edge of the swamp. I can see swamp trees. I don't really want to be tentacle whipped to death.
Freeze, do you have to kill that spider thing like now, or?
Oh my god. Oh man, that was close. See that? There's a tentacle. I was going over to get the stuff that dropped.
It almost killed you, didn't it?
Yes, it almost killed me. Because I thought, well, hey, that must be killing spiders, but the spiders apparently have been unable to destroy it. Oh, there's two tentacles over there. Yeah, unfortunately, that's very unsafe, so I will not be going over there again.
Unsafe tentacle.
I need one more flower. Let's see. I don't know if you can burn tentacles. Probably not. No, it's getting ready to be dark. Let's see. So I have to figure out what I want to burn here. I'm also going to need some more flint. No, that was not enough to kill that tree. Alright, let's stand here in this forest. Because as soon as it goes dark, I should be able to burn down these trees and get some charcoal.
Yeah, burn them.
Yep.
Fire! 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 Fire.
You like to burn things?
Yes.
Hmm. He didn't strike me as a pyro, really.
Oh, I'm not.
Oh.
I especially do not like to burn.
Oh, look at, they do. Here's the blue mushrooms. They do. I was just kind of kidding, but... Oh, no.
Oh.
They're on fire. Quick, get some of these. I'll get this.
Get it.
Yeah, I'm getting them. I have to watch it because of the tentacles over here. It's going to be the fastest game ever.
Mushroom.
I'm getting the mushrooms. Look at those spiders. They're coming out,
yeah,
eating.
That's totally going to make you trip balls.
Oh, I didn't eat it. I don't know if I should eat it. Okay, that's pathetic. Those spiders are coming out, and they're getting immediately killed by the tentacles. Oh, I wasn't standing close enough to a tree. It's so dark. It's so dark. Oh, that's already burnt. Oh, we're almost through the night. Let's see if I can burn anything over here. Nope. Oh, this is burnt already. I really need to get some more flint. The area I started on, there was one piece of flint in the ground. But to be able to make more tools, I need those. So, this is a disastrous start. Let's see if I can get one more fire rolling here. Some pine cones. Alright, let's look at this map. Right, since the swamp is that way, we're gonna head this direction over here. In fact, there's lots of rabbits. Maybe I'll put some traps up. Oh, I can only build one trap. One trap. So I've got to get a weapon or something. Yeah, I loaded the game briefly yesterday, and patching was kind of weird. It didn't work very well for me. I had to uninstall the game and reinstall it. They said that the Steam patcher didn't work for everybody. There was a note about it. So that was the fix for me. It kept suspending my update.
Interesting.
Yep. I need to cook these carrots. Let me briefly make a fire. And cook. Because I need to eat some food. Let's see, let's cook these berries as well. They really need is more stuff to increase your health. There looks like there was a picture in the email that I got of something that restores health, like a potion or something. So there might actually be a way to make a healing potion now. I don't know if it involves mushrooms or not, though. Oh hey, another flint. Yay! Let's see, let's cook this berry. I may hang on to this flint until I get a second one. I really need more rocks. And the only way to get rocks is to find them on the ground or use the pickaxe.
On a big rock?
Yeah. Which I haven't found any of those yet. I don't know what these blue mushrooms do. I guess I should try to eat one and see what happens.
Yeah,
Might as well, since I'm early on in the game.
Yes.
Alright, let's see. I have 178 sanity, 120-ish hunger, and 45 health. It restored a little bit of health.
Really?
Yeah.
And you didn't lose any sanity?
I don't know. Let me see. I have my hat on, so I have sanity increasing, so that's good. Yeah, you lose a little bit of sanity. About maybe 15 or 20.
Is that a
15?
Lot?
Not really. I mean, not when I have this hat on, because it's coming
so
back.
So they do their sanity reducing?
Yes, their sanity reducing. However, it did restore some health. I mean, that's pretty good. So, that's worth it. You know, I'll just keep a good supply of flowers and, you know, until I can make a silk hat of some sort. So we'll just go through and see what I could gather. I am very randomly walking around. This is not a very organized trek through the woods. Yeah, there's a red mushroom. And a second flint. Okay, so now... Oh good, there's lots of flint over here. Now I can actually make a pickaxe. And this area actually looks pretty good. There's some rabbit holes here. I need to find some stone, though, before I stop exploring. I don't know if the red mushrooms do the same thing. That's weird. So there's red mushrooms and blue mushrooms. And the red ones...
They can't have the same effect. That would just...
I don't know.
I mean, wouldn't it make sense to make the red mushrooms and blue mushrooms do different things?
Yeah, I guess so. Well, actually, if you think about it, I don't know if they're actually in this patch, because they didn't mention mushrooms in the patch, like the picture that I got in the email. I mean, maybe they're actually in the patch notes. I haven't read them, but it's possible, because there's three different mushroom types. There's a green one, there's a red one, and there's a blue one. And then
everybody knows red mushrooms are poisonous.
Yeah, that would be bad. I don't really want poison, but I'm gonna have to try them all because I don't know what they do. So I guess that's a slight roguelike element. The first time I get them, I still don't know what they do, and after eating them, you might not know. Mushrooms make you more insane. That's kind of expected, I guess. At least the blue ones do, which means I need to find some more blue ones. But they're only up at night. I know they heal. I guess I need to see if the red ones heal, so I should probably eat this one that I found and see what it does. Right now I have 85 health, so let's see if it kills me. Yes, it does. The red one, actually, it took 20 of my health.
Wow.
So, the red ones do hurt to eat. So, yep, and the blue ones restore 20 health. So,
nice.
Okay. This is good to know. Now I just gotta figure out what the green ones do. I haven't encountered them. I've only seen them before when I was testing the other night.
The real life red mushrooms, death caps. I think that's what they're called.
Oh. Yep. Well, of course I'm gonna try to eat one. See, in reality, I wouldn't have tried that. In a game,
well,
I would try that.
It's like, oh, I'm gonna eat this poisonous mushroom. Yeah. For science!
Yeah, exactly, for science. I would try it. Only in the game universe, or if I knew what it was. I don't think I would know what it was in real life, though. I'm not really up on my mushroom knowledge, my woods things to eat.
Myconology or something like that.
Myconology.
I think so. M-Y-C-O. I mean, I'm probably totally wrong, but I'm close. Myconid is a mushroom, something like that.
You could be right.
I'm sure a scientist. If one was around, could tell us.
A scientist? I don't know any of those. Yeah, Google could also tell us, but yes. I don't actually want to look at Google right now. The study of mushrooms. Oh, here we go. There's a nighttime mushroom. Yes, I picked it in the dark. I can't see what I'm doing at all, and I picked something. Oh, I just burned that. My character likes to burn things. It's mycology. Hey, look! We happen to have a scientist nearby.
Oh.
My gosh. And he studied it.
Oh, wow.
The study of fungi.
That's pretty awesome.
Well, thank you very much for that, Ethan. You're going to have to be our resident scientist, you know. We'll consult you on matters of
science
and technical other things pertaining to science.
Yeah, that's absolutely... That's good life. A good life pro tip right there.
Never eat a mushroom.
Unless you put it as 100% for sure.
Well, right. I mean, of course.
It could be the last mistake you ever make.
Well, so many mushrooms are poisonous. You have to just assume that they are. Unless you know. And I've never studied mushrooms, so I have no idea which ones are and which ones aren't. The ones in the grocery store are not poisonous. The ones in the wild, though, huge mistake. Yeah, I don't know. I know you grew up in a small town, but I can tell you that one of the things about having friends in a small town where you've got woods is you're constantly talking your friends out of bad decisions, like eating things that they find in the woods. And I can remember exploring around at slumber parties with people and having them joke that they're going to eat stuff like mushrooms that they find. And I'm just like, you are the stupidest person ever. Like, here I am, like probably 11 years old, dealing with other people who are dumb enough to think they're cool for threatening to eat a mushroom. At least they didn't, but it would have been natural selection at its finest.
Yeah.
Oh, here's a good story. I have to tell you about the stupidity of 11 and 12-year-olds. When I was in probably 6th grade, so I would have been about 12, there was some kind of magic show on TV. It was like David Copperfield, or I don't know, one of those guys that does the illusions.
Uh-huh.
And one of the things that he was doing was swallowing coins and bringing them back up. Okay. So the next day at school...
Is this on television?
Yes, this is on TV. Okay. This is back when everybody actually enjoyed TV, I guess, because there was nothing else to do. And so this next day at school, this kid that sits in front of me, he saw the show, because everybody saw the show, and he was going to attempt this. Now, obviously, there is no swallowing of the coins going on, you know?
Right.
This kid tries to hide it in his mouth somewhere. He puts a nickel in his mouth, tries to hide it in his mouth. I guess he laughed or something. Something went wrong, but you know where the story is going, right? So he swallows the nickel. And he looks completely shocked and looks at everyone. All of us are like, oh my god, you just swallowed a nickel. And he's like, what do I do? And we're like, I guess you wait now. Like, why? And I kept telling him, I'm like, you shouldn't do that, man. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't do that. Why are you doing that? And he's like, because I saw the magician guy do it. I could do it. And I'm like, man.
Oh god.
This is why there were warnings on TV shows like Beavis and Butthead to not try things at home. Because kids, I mean... I just couldn't believe it. I'm like, why would you do that? First of all, you're not a magician. Second of all, you have no idea how he did the trick. And you're going to pretend to swallow a coin.
Third of all, you were retarded.
You know, I never asked him what happened because I was too disgusted. I think that's totally disgusting, people swallowing things that they shouldn't that. I mean, so I didn't want to know. And I didn't want to ask. And it never came up again. It was just one of those unmentionable situations, I guess. So, oh, I see. Most mushrooms are inedible, so they won't kill you. They just might make you sick. But some of them are deadly. Yeah, it's just not worth the risk. I guess if you're dying of starvation, maybe, and it's not going to matter much, you could always try it. But I don't know. I think I would hold out. It's hard to say, being in a survival situation, what one might do. Speaking of which, I need to eat some of these berries. Hey, I think these berries heal me for more than they used to. Oh, just one? What? One is terrible. Never mind. It was just noticeable there for some reason. Well, I haven't found any good places to camp. I haven't found any rocks either. What I really need to do is start going back around the outside of the perimeter instead of this middle. Because I've got to find different zones. I'm already on day 3. And I don't have a science machine. And I don't have a camp. So I'm gonna have to... get with the program here. There's a little bit of a rush involved in this game because of the hounds. I need to have armor by the time they attack me. Because that way, I won't lose so much health. Although I have 3 blue mushrooms, so I can restore a little bit of health. And I see you, turkey. This is war on turkeys, is what this is. I have zero tolerance for turkeys in this game. I will enact my revenge. That is a very huge wall of text right now in the chat.
Wow.
Let's see. A lot of people have moved to North America from other parts of the world, like Asia, and die from eating mushrooms because their local mushrooms back home are fine. And the ones that look good to them here are deadly. Like Death Angel? What does a Death Angel look like? Death Angel. That's a good name for a mushroom. Hey, what kind of mushroom is that? Is it safe? No, it's a Death Angel, but see, you'd need to know that.
Sounds like a bad, bad mushroom.
It does, actually. It's white. Oh, wow. It looks safe to eat, too, because, I mean, most of the mushrooms at the store are white that you would eat. And... oh, is this a blue... this might be a blue mushroom. What time is it? It is a blue mushroom. Oh, hey, there's a green one. Alright, I don't know what green ones do. I'm gonna...
green mushroom?
Yeah, there's a green mushroom. I'm gonna have to make camp soon, because my inventory is getting full. I'm gonna have to start dropping crap that I don't need. Just gathering like a crazy person. I'm not finding any stupid rocks, so I have to pick up all these flints that I'm finding. Well, let's see. I know there must be rocks around here somewhere. Let's look at the map. Still no rocks. Because I need a rock to be able to build a science machine. Because I need gold. And if I don't get any gold, this is going to be one short gameplay.
Do you always get gold out of rocks?
Not always.
But that's the only way to get it?
Sometimes you can just find it on the ground. Oh, hey, Chester.
Chester?
Yeah. He's here somewhere. It's dark. I can't see
What's
him right
Chester?
Now, actually.
Who's Let me... Chester?
Chester is a... well, he's a chest that follows you around.
Oh, wow. And it's a good thing?
Yeah. Yeah, you can put stuff in him. I think I'm going to drop these for now. Actually, I can drop this red mushroom, because I know it hurts. I don't know what it does, but I'll come back and look for more of them later. Where is he? I have his eye bone. Basically, okay, the way Chester works is he is like a backpack.
Okay.
But he follows you, and if you have the eye bone, as long as you have the eye bone in your inventory, he will follow you around. So if you need to leave him behind for some reason, you just put the eye bone on the ground and he stays near it. I don't know where he is, though, because I'm carrying the eye bone, but I don't see him. So he's usually close by it. This is the first time that I've found the eye bone and not immediately found Chester, so... and of course it's dark, so I can't see anything at all. I'm running around looking for him right now. Well, we'll see where he ends up once it's not dark anymore. I'm gonna continue going down this way. And maybe I will find some rocks, because I badly, badly need a rock. If I don't find rocks soon, I might just have to suicide. Although, I have Chester, so... I don't know. I guess it's possible that he's far away from me. Where are you, Chester? It's so strange. I don't see him anywhere.
Hmm.
Maybe he wasn't near the eye bone this time. That would be the first time I've ever seen that, though. Hmm. Very, very odd. I am by no means an expert on the game. Maybe I have to discover him, too. I guess it's possible he's not with the eye bone.
Interesting. They might have changed it.
Yeah, they might have. I don't know. Because I found him twice before. Again, I didn't play it that much. Like, once they patched and they put him in, I only played it a couple of times, but I found him quite a bit. I don't know. But I have the eye bone anyway, so if he's around, he'll follow me eventually. Chester, why? I need rocks. I guess I'll get these berries. Survival. don't know. That's odd. He's nowhere around. I might have to go back up there and run around, but at this point, it's more important for me to find a camp than to worry about Chester. And I remember he's...
Now, do you find camps or do you build them? Or both?
Well, both. You basically pick a place to settle, and there's a couple of things on the map that make good camps. You've seen that garden place before. Yeah. There's like a pre-made garden area sometimes, and I think that's the only useful, really useful one, but I haven't seen too many other ones. But basically what you're doing is you're setting up a place where you can go back and like do all your research, a place that the science machine will sit.
Right.
So at this point I'm just looking for some stone because I can't really set up a camp without gold because I don't have any gold. I may end up stumbling upon gold just on the ground because I'm not finding any at all. We shall see. I am finding a good amount of flint, which is good. Yeah, but I need gold. Hey, look, there's another red mushroom. Not picking it, though. Poisonous mushroom. No. No, thank you. But I don't even know if they have a use. You would think that maybe red mushrooms were health potions, but I guess the green ones could be.
Yeah.
I have a green one in my inventory. I don't know what it does, so...
How many have you found, green ones? Just one?
Just one. I found the most blue, actually. And it turned out that they were healing, which is convenient, I guess. So, I guess if I'm being chased by something that's killing me, I can always try to eat one while running around. I don't know if I can run around and eat, though. I guess I will find out. Let's see, I'm looking around. My computer is paused over here. I was just looking at it to see what's happening. Do you have the cast running right now? You do. Yeah, a lot of carrots in this game. I picked up 17 carrots. And I've eaten a few more. Oh, look, there's the rain. I don't know that this is a good thing, actually. Because they added this in the patch. This is the rain patch. So, it's starting to rain. I don't know what that means. I don't know if it's hurting me or not. Let's see. Sanity's fine. Health is back to 100. My sanity's going down. Even though I have my flower hat on, so... You know, I bet there was a picture of an umbrella. I bet I'm not supposed to be... allowing myself to be wet. Oh my god. Like, I need more ways to die in this game. It's quite alright. Let's see. I'm gonna put on my...
1001 ways to die. Choose one.
I'll find them. Okay, now I'm back to where my trap was. Let's see.
Or is it 1000 ways to die?
1000 ways to die?
Choose one.
Oh, hey, you can kill animals in your inventory now instead of having to put them on the ground and chop them.
Murder them in your bag.
Yeah, I right-clicked on it.
The murder bag and murder them in the murder bag.
murder bag. That sounds dreadful.
The murder bag.
It's terribly... Oh, God, there's a swamp. It's terribly, horribly dreadful. Awfully, terribly dreadful. Yeah, before, you would have to take them out of your inventory, put them on the ground, and chop them with something. Any weapon would work. I see you, turkey. Went into the bush, damn it. Can't get him when he goes in there. Alright, I'm back. Oh, spider. If only I had some armor. I can't research armor without gold, though. This is not good. And there's those weird-looking things again. I don't know what those are. I don't think I want to get very close to them. Alright, well, the rain has stopped. And you know what? I'm around like a lot of blue mushrooms. I'm gonna see if they pop up at night here. So I'm just gonna...
Okay.
I'm gonna chill here and gather around these. Because I do like the idea of healing. Healing mushrooms. I do need them, that's for sure. But I don't trust those green things over there. I don't know what they are. So I'm going to chop some trees and gather some wood while I'm waiting for dark. Because if I don't chop these down, I'm going to end up burning them. I'm probably going to end up burning a lot of them anyway.
Burn all the trees! Burn all the things!
I guess I can make a campfire. Jeez, alright. Let's see. I gotta find a place to put it. There's so many mushrooms around. Okay, here we go. Yeah, these basic campfires are funny. I think if you're not careful with them, you can actually burn the forest down with them. So, yeah. I'm surprised you don't want to play this game. It's so inherently deadly. Alright.
Yeah.
Yay, blue mushrooms. Wow, they're all popping up everywhere. We're getting them all. No, don't chop. Here we go, get the mushroom. Don't chop! Hitting the space bar, she will go to the closest thing and grab it. So sometimes I'll begin to chop. I just got a bunch of mushrooms. I have 10 now. I can sacrifice a little bit of sanity for health.
Yeah, sanity, who needs it?
Certainly not you.
Oh yeah, whoops.
Well, sanity, I guess losing your sanity doesn't kill you, technically. I mean, it sort of does. I'm going to roast some of this meat. And this meat is delicious. And I feel like I'm going very long without a camp right now. Turkey legs. Let's see what else we have to eat. Carrots.
Give me a second, I'm in the middle of a
cutscene.
Yeah.
Okay. Enjoy your cutscene.
Just don't ask me any, like, deep questions.
Any deep life altering questions? Apocryphile. No, yeah. Oh, I'm just.
Huh?
No, you can concentrate on your cutscene.
Okay.
Oh no, blue mushrooms! They're going away! Come back! No! Yes, Apocryphile is playing Alpha Protocol. He's already beaten it, and is playing it again.
Yeah.
And he's watching me play Don't Starve, so he's multitasking by talking to us,
watching the chat,
watching me play this game, and playing Alpha Protocol. I don't know how you're doing all that at once. I can barely talk. I've forgotten that I heated up my coffee in front of me, and now it's probably cold again. Very sad. I need to move the microwave in here so I don't have to get up. I may never get up again. That's a bad idea.
Never again?
Well, if I have the microwave, I guess I should bring all the food in here into the studio.
Yeah.
You can just have it lined up back here. The microwave. I would need a faucet and probably a bathroom. Now, this is a bad plan. I don't know why I'm even thinking about this. I have some really, really bad ideas sometimes. Also, I still didn't find Chester, which makes me quite sad. Where are you, you bastard? So now I've got to decide. I guess I'm already going down here towards the south, so maybe I'll look there for some rocks. Cooked my carrots. Do I want to cook these berries? Probably. Let's see how many I can cook before my fire goes out. One of the things I like about this character is there's no real urgency to make a campfire.
What about the 7-day thing?
7-day thing?
Like, didn't
you mean the hounds
attack you?
Well, yeah, that has nothing to do with campfires. I mean, that has to do with me being able to plant a science machine down and learn armor. Okay. It's possible that I could survive the hounds the first time because there's only two usually that come after you the first time, and it's just without armor, they just bite right through your clothes and kill you. But, yes, day 6 is about when they show up. The character usually says something that gives you a clue that they're coming. Oh god, tentacle! Run away! Running away, that's my plan. Running away, that's your plan? Yes. There's blue mushrooms growing in the swamp, looks like. Oh, green mushroom. Wait a minute. Green mushrooms aren't up. It's daytime. Oh. I wonder if the green mushrooms only come up during the evening. Like in the orange. This is not a life-altering discussion. It's just me theorizing right now. Can't kill spiders without armor either. It's not wise. Oh my god, a rock.
A rock.
One rock out here in the middle of the freaking woods. Let's see if there was any gold in this rock. Nope. That's not good. Damnation. Alright, I don't need those. This is a terrible, terrible crap. I found a rock. There was no gold to be had. So now I must continue on. There's a grave. Which I can't dig up. Because I can't make a shovel, because I can't make a science machine. You see how this works, right?
Ham.
Yes. Ham indeed. Well, I'm gonna keep exploring. Eventually I'm gonna hit a coast here. Okay, there's a coast. And I guess I can always have a little bit of spider fun. Things that get me killed. Bird in the spider nest and all things around it. Let's see. I also like not taking any fire damage with this character. I mean, when I play the other characters, if I light fires, I run around crazy, but her, she could just stand right on all of it, doesn't matter.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome, actually.
Yeah.
How close can you get to fire on a regular character?
You can't. I mean, what do you mean close? I can't really measure it for you.
You have to get to fire before it burns you.
Pretty close, like a step or two. I mean, I don't really know how to measure it for you. I'd show you, but it doesn't matter.
I mean, I know you can walk right past them with her, but I was wondering how.
Oh, I see.
Like, with another character?
If they're nearby it, I mean, as near as like a tree or something else would burn, it's the same
oh, wow.
Distance.
That's pretty close, actually. Well, I mean, pretty far, because like trees will catch on fire and they're not even right next to each other, right?
Yeah. Yeah, fire hurts you pretty bad, so. Not her, though, which is awesome. Let's see. There's just random rocks. What is this? Pick up rocks. They added a new rock graphic. It's the same thing, it's just a bundle of stones, but it looks different. Okay. Flowers. To keep my sanity up. Oh god, spiders, no. I need more rocks. Let's go up this way. Let's see if maybe I can't believe that there's just one rock. Oh hey, there's a yeah, look at this. The green mushrooms grow during the evening. Okay. There's three different mushroom types, and they all sprout at different times. The blue one is at night, the red one's during the day, and the green one is in the evening, so. Now you feel like you know everything about don't starve mushrooms?
Almost.
Except, what does the green one do? In fact, let's eat a green one. Let's see here. 65, 80, 197. 65, 80. Okay, the green ones give you about 10-ish food. Pretty decent hunger, or a pretty decent sanity hit, and no health. Alright, so I don't know what good the green ones are exactly. They're more for hunger, I guess. Okay, here's another coast. Well, I have plenty of food this time. I see you, turkey. You better be glad it's evening. Once I get into those bushes, I can't get to them. Alright, you know, I think I'm actually gonna go north. Because when I started the game, I had a choice between north and south, and I went south, and it hasn't been working out for me. So I'm gonna go north now and see if that does. Hey, it's dark.
See right here? I am interrogating that guy, and at the end of the game on my first playthrough, he was interrogating me at when I got to the end. So like, through the course of play, it went from me interrogating him to him interrogating me.
That's really weird. Apparently, yeah. Your decisions in Alpha Protocol actually matter. How you talk to people changes the course of the game.
Fuck. Sorry, Ant.
Hey, there's a flint. Let's see here. I'm going around the edge of the coast. Still no rocks, just one rock. I need to actually pick up some flowers for sanity. Shame I'm not running into any blue mushrooms at night. And there's a red mushroom. I'm starting to like the blue mushrooms, the idea of them. This axe, I only have 3% on this axe, it's gotta go. Let's use it and make a new one. Oh god, it's day 6. I still don't have any armor.
It's over. Some guy interrupted me.
What happened? Alright, let's see. Exploring around. I guess I'll chop a few trees on my way. Really need rocks, though. I have to pay attention because the dogs are gonna come soon. Stocking up here to get these. Stop chopping. Let me see if my coffee is still warm. Oh, it is just a little bit. It's a little lukewarm, though. I'm very bad at remembering to actually eat and drink the stuff I go and get. There's a rock. I found another one. Just one. Gold, any gold? Nope. I think this is the first time I've ever had so much trouble finding gold on a map. Oh, hey Joker, how are you today? Thanks for stopping by. As you can see, I'm playing Don't Starve today, having ridiculous bad luck trying to find gold. I have a piece of gold. I might actually be able to make my camp now, let's see. I can! So, now I've got to figure out where to put my camp. I think I found a few spots with some rabbit holes, which would be good. On Timish! Yes, you're on Timish today! Yeah, we haven't been going too long. Let's see, ooh, I'm gonna pick some of these flowers. Let's put these rocks down for a second. Oh man, I must be near a pig camp. I see lots of flowers and lots of carrots.
Carrots are yuck.
Yeah, well, they're good in this game, I guess. Which means I need to clear a spot out for these. I think I'm gonna have to start a fire over here. This is weird, they seem to be by themselves. I think they've changed a few things. Oh no, here we go. Here's the pigs. Pig house is over here.
Yeah, pig house is ham.
I'm not killing the pigs for ham. Whoa.
Well, good luck to you, Joker, when you do the 3-hour.
Oh, nice. The 3-hour Path of Exile race. Is it a solo race today or a party race? Wow, there's a lot of food here. Don't really want to put my camp too close to the pigmen because of werepigs. Let's see, I'm gonna have to drop some things. Let's put these down. Get all these carrots, because carrots are delicious in fictional games. Only in fictional games. Carrots. Well, you know, actually, pickled carrots are pretty good.
Yes.
We did recently have those. And
yes.
We've had them before, but it reminded us that a pickled carrot is actually pretty good.
Pickled carrot on certain things is really good. I don't know if I could just eat pickled carrots, like, straight. I mean, I probably could.
You probably could. You eat pickled ginger straight.
Yeah, but... I mean, just... pickled carrots doesn't sound too appetizing to me.
That's true.
But having them on banh mi is pretty awesome.
Yes. Vietnamese sandwich. Okay, this is ridiculous how few rocks there are anywhere, because I'm going to have to go out again and look for more rocks so that I can make the alchemy machine. Like, I don't know. This is not good. This map is not... It's not good. I have found three rocks to mine. And I need to actually... There's a swamp blocking me. Where else can I go? I could go south here. Also, where did I put that trap down? You know what? I'm going to go back over to where my trap is and see if I can set up camp over there, because that's that north place I want to explore that I was talking about going, so I'm going to go there. Something must be up there. Something. It might not be good, but it's going to be something. More blue mushrooms. I only have 11. And they're food. They go bad. That sucks. You would think that mushrooms would never go bad, but I guess they're like anything else.
Yeah.
Just rots. Let's see. Charcoal. I'm not gonna waste my axe. Alright, there are some rabbit holes. I think this is probably a good place for camp. I think this is where I'm gonna set up now that I have a gold. And I can make my science machine. Build science machine! Oh god, the game is locking up on me. Oh, there it goes. I thought it was gonna die when I built my science machine. How cruel that would have been. It's like my untimely deaths when something cool happens. But I now have my science machine.
Yes.
And so we've gotta get in here and make our armor. Let's see, I need two ropes. And now I can make a log suit. I feel much safer now with this log suit. Alright, so let's drop some stuff.
Log suit.
Actually need to make some more traps, because I have lots of rabbit holes over here, which is good. I think this place is going to be a good camp area. The only question is whether or not I have any rocks nearby, because I'm going to have to go exploring for those. These berries are going bad. I need to eat them. 131. 39. 150. Okay, her max is 150. Alright. I also need to build a chest. Let's see if I can do that. Let's build some boards. More boards. More boards. Chest is... There's chest structures. Cool. And we will put it right there. Alright, so now I can store some stuff. Like extra sticks. And I've used most of my rocks. Burn some pine cones. It's almost daytime, though. In fact, I'll just leave those here. Those petals can rot. Put the seeds away. Eventually, I'm gonna make some farm plots, but you know, I haven't found any beefalo either. Beefaloes?
Is that what they're actually called? Beefaloes?
Well, they're called beefalo.
But I like beefaloes.
I don't know what the plural is.
Beefaloes good. Man on a beefalo, or a guy on a beefalo.
Guy on a beefalo.
Guy on a beefalo.
I don't know what happened to Chester. I'm kind of sad. I gotta find him.
Maybe he's on a beefalo. Maybe he's a Chester on a beefalo.
Maybe the eye bone has a range, and I have to be near him initially when I pick it up, and I just, maybe I walked the wrong direction. Don't horse lip in my general direction.
Huh?
Yeah, so I gotta figure this out. I'm gonna cook these carrots. I have a ton of food right now. Starving isn't what's going to happen to me. Show yourself. Okay, you know, I think the dudes might
Maybe
be coming
the
soon.
Maybe the game is called Don't Starve because it's the most embarrassing way to die possible.
That's very possible. Oh, you know what? I need to make a spear.
Maybe they put it there because the game, like, the food is in there, but no one ever starves to death, so they called it Don't Starve because they're like, what's the most stupidest way someone could die in this game? Starving to death.
Yeah, it would be kind of stupid, I guess. But, I mean, sometimes you don't find food. I mean, it's not always your fault. You'll be, like, exploring around, and sometimes there's just nothing to find.
Mm.
It takes forever to explore around. I think that's the randomness of the maps.
I see.
But yes, it is pretty stupid. Oh my god, there they are. You are gonna die, my friend. I just made a spear, and just put it on, and just put on my log suit, and here they come. Seriously, I just equipped the spear. I was like, I should make a spear. And he comes running in. So, that was good timing. I survived the hounds!
And that was day 7.
Yes, day 7. They seem to just kind of show up randomly, because there's no time of day that they universally...
But they come on day 7.
Yep, and they will run right for your camp.
That sucks.
Your camp is not safe. Although I think you can build walls. I just don't know what the benefit of that is. Like, I think the hounds can get in, but... Like, if you close the walls in, then you wouldn't be able to get out. So I'm not really sure what the point of the walls is. Fortress building, not the best at the moment in the game. Right now I'm going to have to think about building a refrigerator. Okay, so you check this out. I have rabbits in my inventory.
Okay.
Instead of having to drop them, I can just right-click on them now and kill them and turn them into meaties.
Nice.
Yeah. That's very,
Efficient?
Yes, that's the word I was looking for.
Thank you.
Efficient.
Yeah, that apparently has happened in the patch because... oh yeah, look, it says right mouse button, murder.
Nice! It is a murder bag!
That is what it says.
That is awesome, murder.
It says murder.
Murder. It's awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Alright, we'll take it. Well, this is very sad. I don't know what to do with this eye bone. I have to carry it around if I'm going to actually look for Chester. Oh, man. And I need to make a crock pot because my food is going bad. And a fridge to make my food last longer. Let's see. Crock pot needs charcoal, which I know I burned a forest, but now I can't remember which one I burned. I might have to just go set fire to something else. But I still need rocks. So, let's see, where was that fire that I set? I don't remember. Where did I burn the forest down? Where? I don't know. Let's chop these trees down, they anger me. I'm not gonna burn these trees. They probably added some new items to the science machine. I'm gonna stick close to town, and when it's dark, I'm gonna go look through there and see what they added. See if it's anything I might be able to use mushrooms for. Let's see, let's eat these. That tasted terrible. Still food. Let's see, yeah, there we go. Might as well eat them, even though they're rotting. Rotting berries probably taste like mush. And gross. But at least it's food. I need some more grass, too. I used a lot of my grass making all these traps. Let's see if I can kill this rabbit. No! Oh, hey, look at this. The forest is right here. I was like, I wonder where I burned all those trees. It's like right next to where I set up camp. I did explore quite a wide area of stuff unsuccessfully, looking for rocks. At least I got one for the science machine, but now I need like 6 more. Well, I'm gonna pick up this charcoal. Charcoal's a really good fuel, too, for the fire. It burns stronger and brighter, faster than some of the other stuff. So I'm picking that up now. Let's see. And then... Then I must figure out what else I'm going to do. Probably go searching for rocks. I know it sounds like I'm obsessing over rocks, but that's pretty much what I need at this point. I see you, spider. Away with you. Upgrading weapons over there?
Yeah.
How good is the weapons system in Alpha Protocol?
It's not bad. It's not bad. It's lots of customization, lots of different weapons to pick.
Is it intuitive or fun, or is it kind of annoying to upgrade?
It's intuitive. I mean, switching weapons is really easy in the game. You just press one button. But yeah, it's pretty easy to figure out.
That's cool. As I can see, you've got different mods on there and stuff.
Yeah.
You've got barrels and sights, magazines, accessories. That's pretty
cool. Yeah,
that's
pretty cool.
So, let's see what the science machine has that's new. Let's see, how fashionable a straw hat. Beefalo. They are called beefalo.
Nice.
I keep saying beefaloes. Plural, though, because I don't know if
yeah,
it's actually...
That's a good word.
I have found the many beefalo. Or
beefalo's
is it the many beefaloes? Well, I like the way beefaloes sounds, so I would just say that anyway. But
that's a good one. Beefaloes.
Beefaloes. And here we have the beefaloes. It's a shame I can't take on tentacles just yet, because I would like to be able to go over there and pick up all the spider silk that one keeps generating, because the spiders come out, get pissed off, fight the tentacle, and die. Spider versus tentacle. Spiders lose.
Yeah.
Me versus tentacle. I lose. I don't know how to fight those things. Every time I've tried to fight one, it's killed me, so...
Well, you probably
I
don't
still...
fight one.
Well, you can. They drop stuff. You can actually make a weapon, a spiked, like, plank or something out of what they drop.
Wow, damn.
I have no idea how. I've just seen other people do it.
Is there ranged weapons in this game?
There is. There's a boomerang, which that is one of my plans, to make a boomerang and try to kill the tentacle, which would be the safe way, but I just don't know how to run away from them yet, because when they come up and they whip at you, you can actually move out of the way. I don't know the timing of it yet, so...
I see.
I think what I might do is start a couple games... Search specifically for swamp and then just practice moving out of the way with no armor.
Because,
I mean, swamps. Swamp a shoe?
Yes.
Because if I move out of the way and they don't hit me and I'm not wearing armor, it doesn't matter because they're missing me. And once I learn how to do that, then I'll be able to take them on a little bit better.
Nice.
So just, it's a matter of learning how to fight them. Oh my god, I stood here the whole time and I only looked at a couple things from the science machine. I get so preoccupied. Breezy vest. Alright, nothing too new in there. Purple gem. Purple gem is new. What is this? Gems. I didn't know. Look at this. By your colors combined, a purple gem. I don't know what that means. Apparently you can find a red gem and a blue gem and they do something.
Yeah, who knows?
Oh, maybe in rocks. Maybe.
Well, yeah.
Sometimes they just...
What would you use them for?
A purple gem? I don't know.
That makes me very grumpy.
Oh no. I've made Apocryphile grumpy.
It's a terrible thing.
It's pretty easy to make
it's
you grumpy.
Thing, I tell you.
I need more rocks. I need rocks now because I have to also build a crock pot which takes rocks, and I think a refrigerator takes rocks as well. Let's see. Drying rack. Wait, where's the refrigerator? Why isn't it in here? Farm plot, speedy farm plot, crock pot, drying rack, the jerkiest of racks.
The jerkiest of racks.
It's a drying rack. Oh man, I can make that too, I think. Let me see. Wait, does it require an alchemy machine? Hold on. Use a science machine. Okay. So I need to make ropes. I don't know what to
make jerky. Beefalo jerky. Yum.
Oh man, well let me get that ready. I'll probably die before I get to use it, but I might as well try to, try to unlock it. It's new. But I'm not seeing the fridge. It's usually in here. I guess... Oh, maybe I wasn't close enough to the machine. Here we go. Icebox. There it is. I need an alchemy machine for the icebox anyway. Oh my god. Of course. Of course I need an alchemy machine. An alchemy engine. Let's make this rack. What the hell? Wow, look at it. It's actually a... Examine drying rack. I want to hang some meat. Okay. Whoa. Interesting. Okay, so I was able to put a morsel of meat on there. Just one. And when you look at it, she says, Come on, meat, dry already. So it's like a farm plot, I guess. I have to wait for the meat to mature. To dry. That's pretty cool. That's one new thing they added I haven't seen before. My god, I'm losing sanity. I need to make a new... This is not good.
Sanity. Who needs it?
You don't, obviously.
Nope. Absolutely not.
Well, I'm gonna have to... I gotta get some flowers or something. Let's see, I thought I had flowers. Oh, you know what? I think I put them away. But they're getting kind of rotted in this pile. I guess it's better than nothing. Gotta get this hat. There we go, shoe. Worry about that later. Monster meat. Morsels. I don't really want to attract Krampus. I'm assuming Krampus is still in the game. So I can't just stand here and endlessly kill rabbits. Doing okay on food. I wonder how long it takes the meat rack to dry. Meat. Maybe I should make another one. Oh wait, I don't quite have enough. Straw? Yeah, I don't really have enough straw. So what do I have? Let us start a small fire and cook some of this carrots. You found an orange! Dude, that's awesome! Joker found a legendary item.
What?
Yeah.
Congrats, man.
Which one did you find? That's rad.
Yeah.
Very rad. It's always good to... The first one you find is the best one.
Yes.
Even if it's a crappy one.
Man, I hope it carries you all the way through to number one.
Oh, hey, this is new, too. I made a flower hat out of the flowers, and my flowers were... Look, see how they are?
Nice, man. Hit point ring.
Well, see how it's...
Yeah.
Like... I guess see how they're decaying and there's only like a little bit of red left? Mm-hmm. I made the hat and it's full green. Normally in the old patch, when I would make the hat, it would be at the same like rotted level as the flowers had been. So that's different.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
A coral ring? Wait a second, what was our first item? We got the coral... wasn't the coral necklace. What is that necklace called?
It was a necklace. Coral necklace.
Yeah, it is a coral
necklace. Coral ring.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Because it's the health regen necklace is the first one that we ever got.
Health ring. That's pretty awesome.
That is pretty awesome. Very cool, man. Maybe there's like a thing about coral being the first.
Probably not.
Just chance?
Yeah.
See, that's how random works. Truly random doesn't feel random. Because you're like, there must be an explanation for this. Here's my fire. Let us light the fire again. Oh, I can't cook mushrooms. I can only put them in the fire. Well, whatever. Let's see. Debating making another rack. Oh, hey, I've got rot in my inventory now. So if I make some farm plots, I'll be able to fertilize them with my rot. Rot. I'll just put this in the ground. That's terrible. This game is so bittersweet. I just enjoy pretty much doing nothing and wandering around having a good time, and then monsters come and kill me and take away all my fun. That's when the stress happens. I feel like I should be better at killing them. Wait. What should I do now? Let me see. See, this is the problem that you would have it being a sandbox game. At this point, you'd be like, what do I do?
Yeah.
I don't know, just time to quit. No, yeah, I'm just gonna quit.
I like direction.
I don't know. Would you like SimCity? Like, does SimCity have enough direction for you?
Well, I mean, yeah, because there's, like, things to build, and I don't know, like, I can upgrade buildings.
Like, when your Sims say, hey, I need some more residentials, and you would be like, oh, now I need to work on residentials, and that gives you direction. This
like,
game
I've always
doesn't
liked
really...
SimCity type games and like Civ and stuff like that. But like stuff like this where it's just like, alright, here you are, you're in a forest. Have fun.
You're in a forest.
I gotta eat. That's your
food.
One rule, don't starve.
Don't starve. Well, don't starve and don't get killed. I mean, technically, now that they have these three circles, you have health, so you're not supposed to die. You know, you're not supposed to just lose all your health by getting bitten by monsters. You're not supposed to starve by forgetting to eat, which, you know, I forget to eat all the time. And then you're not supposed to... I need to cook these. And then you're not supposed to go crazy. Because insanity, essentially the monsters will come after you. The idea is with the insanity that there are all these shadow monsters around, and you can't see them when you're sane, and they can't really see you, but when you're insane, you start noticing them, and they notice you, and then want to kill you. So,
right.
They're there. They're always there. Just only the insane people can see them. So, in a 3-hour race. And what level were people getting to in a normal 3-hour race? The other day we were guessing levels. Do you remember what level that they were getting to in 3 hours? Was it like 30 something?
Yeah, 34, I think. 31. I can't remember anymore.
Yeah, me either. Me either. I have to be in the mood to race. I definitely feel like taking my time today. I'm a little more awake than yesterday. And decided against Crater. Crater was fun yesterday, but it's a little slow. And there's a lot of reading to do. The text is really small, too, so I don't even know how easy it is for viewers to read the quest text. And I don't really want to read it all out loud, because there's a lot of it.
Yeah.
But at some point, we're going to be revisiting Crater, most likely. Because I really want to get to the next town and see the next guys that I can recruit. See what kind of level 5s there are. Check and see if there's any other skills and whatnot. It's a pretty cool game. It almost feels like it's the kind of RPG that you just sit and quietly play by yourself, though. I'm not sure. And all the casting we've been doing lately. The other day, I loaded up SimCity to try it. And as I'm playing it, I started talking out loud to myself. It's almost like now I can't play a game by myself quietly. Because I just sit and start talking, and I had to stop. Because I'm like, no one's listening. Apocryphile's over here trying to play Alpha Protocol, RPG, enjoying himself. And I'm just like, it's SimCity. I wonder if I need to put down some residentials over here. Like, I'm talking to an imaginary audience all the time now. So, I don't know. I can't. But yeah, but... No, you're not imaginary. You were just not watching me play. Like, I had no reason to tell you what I was doing. See, normally I'll sit here and if something cool happens, I'm like, hey, check this out. And you'll go, what? And then you'll look and I'll tell you. But when you're casting, you talk about the game constantly. It's constant talking. I mean, I don't know. It would be kind of boring if I just sat here and was like...
Yeah, I've seen people do that before, though. They just play and they have a camera on themselves and they don't say anything.
I guess it's a choice between really concentrating and interacting with people or just... coming up with something interesting to say. Sometimes I don't even know what I'm talking about. I'll just be saying something. It doesn't matter. Maybe I can lull people to sleep with my light 101.4 easy music voice. That's what I'll do. That's probably not good, though. Not while Joker's doing his race. I probably shouldn't encourage sleep. I'll end up relaxing. I just ate a raw piece of meat by accident. That's probably not what I wanted to do. Kind of feeling a little guilty for murdering these cute little animals. Let's eat some carrots. They're stale. How delicious. And I'm surprised this game doesn't have salt. Because salt would be a really good preservative. But you'd have to... I mean, they let you mine. So you would think that salt would be a good choice. That's what they should do. When you're mining rocks, salt could come out sometimes. And then if you take the salt and apply it to your food... it would extend the life of it a little bit.
That'd be cool.
I should suggest that. I wonder if anybody suggested it. It would be rare like gold. Like, it wouldn't have to come out all the time.
Yeah.
Alright, well, these carrots are getting old. I don't know what to do with these stupid mushrooms. My blue mushrooms are getting yellow. See, I would love to be able to apply some salt to my mushrooms or something so that I could extend their life. Let's check the meat rack. Harvest drying rack. Oh, look, it's done now. You know, I bet these this small jerky lasts a really long time, because like jerky is a way of preserving meat.
Yeah.
So maybe it's not going to go bad as long. I wish I could dry more than one at a time. Okay, I need to gather some more shit. I like being in my camp. My camp is fun for me. I need to leave and go find some damn rocks. Alright, I must leave the camp. Much to my sorrow. Because I have to gather some more grass. Alright, there's some bees. I have explored this area, but let's get some berries. Berries, berries. Oh no, you keep dying? What's killing you in the lower submerged passage?
Oh man, that sucks.
Is that where the crab is?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm trying to remember if that's the ultimate lower level where the crab is, or is it just the first entrance you go in. Night is coming, I need fire. Night is coming, I need blue mushrooms. I don't think there's any up here. Oh, disconnecting is killing you? That sucks, man. It seems like a lot of people are reporting that, though. Like, the races have been disconnecting people more than usual lately. I don't know. What level are people getting up to now, have you noticed? I guess it's only been about 19 minutes, so... First entrance. Okay. So that's right after you put the glyphs in. That's what it's called, the lower submerged. Oh, I think it's called something like the depths or something
lower
like that.
Depths
lower
or something
depths,
like that.
Yeah, where the crab is. I always skip the crab in races.
Yeah.
See here, I got grass. I'm up to 24 grass. 9. That's not bad. Jesus Christ. Level 9 in 19 minutes. It's insane. How do they do it?
I have no idea.
I'm going to watch some videos on that because I want to see how the speedrunners are doing it. Like what the strategy is now. Oh my god, there are rocks. Okay, look at this. Look at this map. When I started like here.
Yep.
And I decided to go down. And
you've gone up just like 50 feet.
Yes. I've done this before. I mean, you have decisions to make, right? So I had all these directions. The direction I didn't go, because, you know, you got the four directional compass
right.
type thing. I didn't go south. I was down here, I can see there's a wormhole, and I was like, you know, I'm going to go back up there and go north, because that was one of my first choices, and I didn't take it. And, well, if you look,
yeah,
look at that, there's a rock.
Yep.
Oh, wait, maybe it's just one. But I'm excited, there's probably more up here somewhere. This is ridiculous. Flooded Depths is the name of it. I'm very bad at remembering the names of the maps. I think part of it is because when I sit back and relax, I'm really far from my screen. I can't actually read the names, so I don't really think of them as important. Same thing with the enemies. Like, when Apocryphile and I are playing, and we run into, like, the boss-type guys, the yellow guys, he'll read all of the status things on them, like what they do, because I cannot see it. Can't see it. I'm thinking I need to get my eyes checked again. Because my glasses, I should be able to see well with them, and I can see bigger text, but... Need some. I don't know. Maybe my eyes are just broken. It's been a couple years though since I've had my eyes checked. I searched the desert for 2 hours on my new Minecraft world. It was terrible. Oh man, that sucks. No good resources or any good place to put a city. Man, one of my favorite things to do in Minecraft is finding the towns. Like looking for the townsfolk. And seeing what I can trade to them for emeralds. And if you end up finding a place where you can mine emeralds, those, what do they call those, mountain areas, I don't know. Like, you end up with quite a few. This rock, I want this rock. Building a campfire so I can have this rock. Alright. We are gonna mine this rock. Oh, you were looking for a desert and you couldn't find one. You need a cactus. Dude, that sucks. I like using cactus as a fence around my property to keep things out, like spiders. And spiders will just climb over everything in Minecraft. But they can't climb a cactus once they're fully grown. It kills them, which is very nice. Let's see. Let's eat these carrots. Some berries. And one more. Yeah, I haven't played Minecraft in a while. I think the last time I played was maybe December. I played it for quite a lot. It was marathon sessions by myself, and got a little burnt out on it, which is what I do. I'll play it until I can't stand it anymore, and then move on. What in the world? What are these things? Oh, this doesn't look good. Evil flowers? What the hell is an evil flower? I don't like this. Apocryphile, what's an evil flower?
An evil flower? Yeah, it's going to bite you like
Look at that thing. It looks like a Cthulhu or something.
Or maybe not. I don't know.
It's thorny. I don't know what that is. There's a bee. The bees are hanging out. Look, the bees can go play with the evil flowers.
Pick it.
Well, I'm going to have to because I don't know what the hell they do.
Oh, just don't eat it.
Well, no. I'm going to try not to eat it.
Let's see.
It could be a big mistake. All right, bee.
It could be a big mistake, but that's why you got to try it.
Dark petals. What in the... What do they do?
You probably should not eat the dark petals.
You know, I probably shouldn't pick them either.
Why?
Well, because I don't know what to do with them yet. I just need to remember they're here, because if I pick them, they'll rot if I don't figure out what to do with them. So I know they're here. You know what I need to do is mark this area, because... What is this ring thing? Did you see this thing? In the middle? Pick up ring thing.
Oh, I thought that was a wormhole at first.
No. Well, I don't know what this is either. This is too precious to burn. You know what? This might be one of those quest items that's meant for the adventure mode.
Yeah, maybe. I'll be right back, actually.
I don't know. Can you heat up my coffee, actually, while you're up? I would really appreciate that, because it is bone cold and is making me sad. I have about a half a cup of my coffee left. Yeah, sure. Sure, whatever. Whatever you feel like doing. I don't know. I'm kind of freaked out by these items, because... Yeah, that's all we have left. Because I don't really know what this stuff does, and I don't have any good way of figuring it out without cheating. Okay, why is there just a morsel on the ground, and it's stale? I'll just pick it up. And, put it in my stack. Okay, I need more rocks. I only found one rock. Okay, apparently going north was not the solution to all my problems. Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to have to eat this one dark flower. You're right, Joker. I will try that when Apocryphile gets back so he can see what it does, too. Yes, I'm going to eat it. I have to know what it does. I can't just find something new in the game and not risk my life by eating it. I have to try it, so we'll do it. What is this? I got all this new stuff. I have no idea what's happening. All right, that is... Nitra... Nitre? I don't even know how to pronounce that. It is... What did she say? There are tiny explosions trapped inside. Oh, you know what? They added gunpowder in the patch. This probably has something to do with gunpowder. See, they sent me an email with this poster and a picture of things, and rather than actually read the actual patch notes to figure out what's going on, I was like, oh, hey, look, an umbrella and gunpowder and, like, some various other stuff. Thank you. And so I didn't really see what anything did, but I kind of have an idea of what they added. So I'm going to guess that this new rock type is related to gunpowder. I don't know. It's my best guess. You guys will watch as I try to figure out what the hell I'm doing in this game. I'm very stubborn about looking up secrets. At some point I get frustrated and look it up, but right now I just don't care. I don't care what it does. Oh my god, gold. I totally need that. Let's see. Dust drop. Something. What will we get rid of? Man, I still lost Chester. Oh, if only Apocryphile was back. We would eat this dark flower. And I'll get myself killed. Well, I will get myself killed eventually. Because I still need the XP to unlock three more characters. The next character I have to unlock, the robot's coming up. Joker, so... I am going to die at some point, probably sooner rather than later. Oh my god, Beefalo. Yay, Beefalo! And I just do not have enough inventory space for all these good things I'm finding. Let's see... I can't eat that either. I don't really need this torch. This character does not need torches. She's quite the rebel. Hello, Beefalo. So, let's see. Do you have Don't Starve, Joker? I can't remember if you said you have this game or not. There's so many games. I can't keep track of anything. This game is pretty fun and pretty difficult. Man, you know what? Let me look at the map. Okay, the beefaloes are not marked. So I'm going to put a trap here to remind myself to come back, because that's where the beefaloes are. trap. Put the trap down. I want the grass. And I'm so tempted to try and kill the beefaloes, but I know that they're tough. They're tough bastards. That's usually how I get myself killed, too, by the way. It's like, I haven't tried killing this monster before, or, you know, whatever, this animal. I'm gonna go kill it. My raids on the spiders are the worst. Because if I don't go and just burn everything to the ground, it's usually a complete disaster. Let's see. Okay, I don't need any more of that. I will make another trap and put it here. Because there's actually a rabbit hole there. Coffee is good. And look how many berries I have, and they're all spoiled. Oh, if only I could make a crock pot. You know, how far away from my camp am I? Pretty freaking far. I think I need to keep destroying rocks for a while longer. Oh, hey, it's a full moon. It's a full moon. Let's light a fire on the ground, shall we? So I'll put a campfire down while I'm doing this. I don't need to burn everything all the time. This character loves burning everything, though. Yeah, the new patches are always exciting because there's so much stuff in here. I have no idea what exactly they've added. All I do is look at the email briefly and try not to spoil it too much, and then get in here. I did briefly see somebody playing the game, but I left before I saw too much else. They added mushrooms, and I have no idea what they do. I haven't seen any recipes in the science machine, so maybe there's something in the alchemy machine. We'll see what's in there. And mushrooms, it does kind of seem like an alchemy thing, though. Like potions of some sort. I've just been eating them to see what they do. Oh god, I'm losing sanity. I need something. Actually, let me pick up these rocks very carefully. I need something to eat that does not lower my sanity. Maybe these berries. No, berries don't. My sanity's rising, but very slowly. Gonna have to go pick some flowers, I guess. So that still works. Here's a flower. Picking good, nice flowers. There's another one. Let's see if there's some more over here. So are you gonna keep racing, Joker, or are you gonna call it quits? You still got a couple hours. Got, what, 2.5 hours left at this point. Still time to do something heroic. Guess it depends on the disconnect. Oh no, accidentally slashed at a bee. He was on a flower. Let's see if I can kill him. I accidentally slashed a bee while I was trying to pick... never mind. He just decided to stop attacking me, so I'm not going to attack him. I was trying to pick a flower, and he was on it, and I accidentally attacked instead. Because I'm trying to restore my sanity. My sanity's kind of bad. I'm starting to see shadow animals and stuff. Okay, so you're back. This is probably going to be a huge mistake, eating this dark petals. But I'm going to eat it, and we'll report what it does. Alright, let's see, here we go. Dark petals, 127, 135, 90. Oh, it's just a sanity hit. So, that's not bad. What the hell does it do? No. It didn't do anything else. So, yeah, eating the dark petal didn't really do anything except make me more insane, which is what I don't need right now. But it didn't actually, like, hurt me, really. That's not bad. I mean, just eating normal flowers makes you kind of nuts, so... I don't know what the dark petals are for. I'm gonna have to figure that out. I'm gonna get to 10. Oh, is 10 the minimum right now? Oh yeah, while you're away, Apocryphile, I also have discovered a new rock type. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It's either Niter or Nitra. Nitra, I guess. Well, yes, actually. Yeah, that's what I was guessing from the email that I got, is that it has something to do with gunpowder. Exactly what, I don't know. Let's build another pickaxe. I've got a few pieces of it, which is good. And I've got some gold. I have 8 pieces of gold. You know what? I can go back to camp now after I found some rocks up here. It took me a while to get to them. They were not as close as I previously thought they were, so I wouldn't have found them as quickly, but it wouldn't have taken me this long either. Like, that was just one by itself. Alright, mushroom. The red mushrooms are kind of dangerous. I'm gonna leave that one there. The Joker is gonna attempt to get to 10 in the race today, which is good. 1 point. Yeah, apparently the season, I looked at the season calendar, it goes through April. So you have at least until April if you want to attempt to get 15 points. So it doesn't end at the end of March. I was concerned that it was going to be too short for my attention span. We actually have time if we want to participate in a couple more. And it'll give us time to play other games as well. But I'm just walking around. Oh, you don't have your headset on yet. I'm just walking around picking flowers too, trying to restore my sanity a little bit.
Yeah.
Just eating when I come in contact with. Let's see, I need some more of these branches. I'm kind of headed back down to camp. I can't believe I accidentally slashed a bee.
I can.
Ugh. What does that say about me?
You hate bees?
Well, yes. Who doesn't hate bees? Farming ledge, yay! Yeah, the ledge is a good place to farm. It's fun. Fun to hang out there. Alright, turkey. Where did you just go? Get out of that bush. Oh my god, I hate you. Hate turkeys. Hate. Especially when they get in the bushes, because I can't do anything about it. They go in there, they eat the damn berries, and then I can't kill them. Stupid turkey bastards. Alright, you know I need to stop going this direction and go back to my camp.
Man, I thought my time stamps were supposed to show up, but it's not working.
Yeah,
like,
recheck it again. The box is probably unchecked.
What happens is when someone says something, it puts a timestamp on it, right?
Right.
But if one person keeps talking,
uh-huh.
Like Joker, the first thing he said was at 11:50,
mm-hmm.
And every time he puts a line in, it doesn't do a timestamp for every line, only the first line.
Oh.
So basically, if there's a bunch of people talking, it can tell you when.
Mm-hmm.
But if only one person is talking, it only shows you the first line. So.
Well, then you might have to type something every once in a while if you want to care about that. True. I don't care. I have the chat. I can actually see the chat today. I have it on the same screen as Don't Starve, because Don't Starve is awesome that way. Adjusting the size of the screen doesn't affect it too much, so I can actually look at it. Ham?
That's right.
That's all you have to say is ham?
Yeah.
Okay. It seems appropriate.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm back at the dark flowers again. Which, let's see. You know, I don't think did I ever put down a trap or anything here? There really isn't anything on the map to mark these dark flowers, so I probably should. Alright, I will put this trap right here so I can remember that it's there. Bacon. Oh, delicious bacon. I want some delicious bacon. I actually went to the store yesterday and picked up some random stuff. Mostly I came back with mac and cheese, but I should have gotten bacon. I don't know why I didn't. It's like every time I say I want bacon, and then I end up not getting any. Bacon is expensive, that's usually why. Let's see what I light on fire this time. Oh, nothing, just a field. Good. Alright then. Continue on. It's so dark! I don't know why bacon is so good. Like, why is it so good? I don't know if it's the saltiness, the greasiness, the meatiness. But apparently, speaking of mac and cheese, apparently mac and cheese is gourmet right now. In our town. Yes? In our town, there's this place. They serve mac and cheese, and they put all kinds of weird gourmet stuff in it. It's like, it's kind of like this little trendy shop. I don't really know why mac and cheese is so hyped up, but I went to this store yesterday and they had
and
these.
I'm gonna forget. I can't really talk when this is happening.
That's fine.
The mac and cheese place is not the same.
Not the same as what? Oh wow, this beef jerky or whatever lasts a really long time. Small jerky.
Dude, these are like cut. They like last for 10 minutes, like the cutscenes.
Oh. Well, you don't have to answer me. I mean, I was just talking.
It's not Mac Daddy's anymore. It's something else now.
Oh, is it gone completely?
No, it's just something different.
Oh. Well, I don't know. I didn't know the name of it anyway, but it was just a mac and cheese place. But they have, like, tons and tons of mac and cheese flavors. Still not tried it. People have told me about it. But, the store even has it, too. It's like, not only do you have mac and cheese, but you have these weird flavors that they're like, I don't know, like Mexican flavor or like gourmet cheddar cheese with breadcrumb sprinkles. It's just really weird. Mac and cheese is not mac and cheese anymore. It's just really odd flavors. Broccoli sauce. Broccoli and cheddar mac and cheese. It's like Metal Gear Solid 4, Ethan says. 90 hours of cutscenes! Yeah, not only is it a lot of cutscenes, but he has to like, he has to respond. There's like a quick time text response, and he has to pick what kind of ways he's responding to these people in Alpha Protocol. Like, do you respond professionally, or like a veteran, or suave?
Yeah, it wouldn't be so bad, but it's timed.
Yeah, so you have to press the button fast. You have
so
to read it.
I have to, like, pay attention.
Well, you knew it might be difficult to hit a couple of them, so. Hey, look, more rot. Pick up this rot and put all this rot together if I can. Rot on the ground. Here we go. Good fertilizer for if I ever decide to plant something. Oh, my blue caps are spoiled. Let's see what happens if I eat a spoiled blue cap.
I just look over and look at Ethan's things. 90 hours of cutscenes!
Yeah, that's what I was reading earlier. Yes, yes. It's impossible to get through some games.
90 hours of cutscenes, yeah!
Are they good cutscenes, though? What is it? Metal Gear Solid 4?
Sure, dude, Metal Gear Solid 4? I'm sure they're awesome.
Well, it's
but
Metal...
It's, like, fun to play every now and then, too.
Metal Gear Solid is a pretty good game franchise,
yeah.
But the question is 4 still good? Like, because when you get to, like, you know, the third or fourth installment, sometimes they're not good. But I have no idea. I've never played that one, so couldn't tell you if it's good or not. All right, I'm back at the science machine, and I think I should be able to make an alchemy machine if I have all the right stuff. So let's see. I need some stone, which I got plenty of. I got one in the chest here. And let's see. I only need a 2 stone. And I need 4 boards. Okay. Let's get 4 boards if I have enough wood. If not, I'm gonna have to go out and get some more. Yep, I'm gonna have to go get some more wood. Time to put the coffee cup down. Let's see if there's any trees over here. There's a big tree, that's perfect. Which I'm gonna have to make another axe. Let's see. That's pretty funny, actually. Talking about Final Fantasy VII as the game where you don't play. Because they were talking the whole time. Yeah. It's kind of like that. Oh, I guess I shouldn't drop these. I should plant them. So I'm probably going to need some trees at a later date. Yeah, Final Fantasy XIII is kind of, I don't know, until you beat the game, you're just stuck doing what they want you to do. It's very linear for a long, long time. I guess it became more like a real Final Fantasy game after you beat the boss, which is kind of weird because you would think... Oh no. Oh, shoo. Tree Spirit. Tree Spirit was not happy to see me killing his trees. Goodbye, Tree Spirit. You can rest there quietly. Yeah, the game didn't actually get fun, I guess, or traditional at any rate until after you beat it. So where you could just kind of go around and grind if that's what you like to do in the games. Alright, let's get this alchemy machine rolling. I think I can finally do it.
I'm just now catching up, reading Ethan's comments. Oh man. I didn't start liking 13 until after I beat the game and I got to wander around the...
Yeah, I was just talking about that.
Calm Lands. It was, I can't remember anymore.
I think if you would ask me if I cared about Final Fantasy XIII, the answer would be no.
It's really disappointing, but... I mean, I did have a lot of fun farming those humongous adamantoise things. Longui, or whatever they were called. Yeah, Grand Pulse, that was it. Yeah. I had a lot of fun farming and... getting every achievement.
Yeah, once the end opened up, you seemed to be a lot happier.
Yeah. I loved beating the crap out of those humongous things. It was so fun.
Yeah, it kind of surprised me how you really didn't have any freedom. I mean, it's like what Ethan's saying. The game won't walk through these one-dimensional hallways itself.
Yeah.
I mean, that's how the game felt to me. And I watched you play, and I thought that I would start playing, and I really didn't get that far through it because... I had watched him do that already. It was boring. It was the exact same thing over again. You know, it wasn't like I had any choices to make that were different.
Right.
You know. It just sucked all around. I was not very pleased with that experience. Although I've heard that 13.2 is better. That they improved upon it a little bit. But I don't know. I'm a little disillusioned. After 13 sucked, and the first Final Fantasy 14 online sucked, and a lot of their previous games had sucked, I guess I was willing to give them a lot of chances, but at this point I'm just kind of like, I just don't care as much as I did before. The last good Final Fantasy game I played was Crisis Core on my PSP. Crisis Core was good. It wasn't as good as some of the old games. The mechanics were kind of more on the side of their new mechanics, but because I like the Final Fantasy VII mythos and world, it was enjoyable for me. It felt very fan service. You know, it's personal, and I don't think that if I didn't like Final Fantasy VII in general, I probably would not have embraced that game. But I did actually enjoy it. But it has just been a long time since I've really had a Final Fantasy game that I've enjoyed. So who knows? Maybe they'll get it right one of these days. I should cook these meats. I really wanted to dry them, but drying rack takes so long. I don't want these to go bad, so I'll see if they should improve. And then I can try putting them in the crock pot. Maybe with, let's see, I have berries. JRPGs have to walk a line between no freedom, like Final Fantasy XIII and games like Ultima and Saga Frontier. Oh god.
Saga Frontier.
Saga I've heard Frontier.
You tell stories about that game.
Yeah, Saga Frontier. I mean, there's no real direction in that game at all. They pretty much just let you just go. You've got all these different characters, and they all have plots to pursue, and they don't really. You do whatever you want. It's very weird. I enjoyed it, but there were times that I was completely lost as to where to go and what to do. I'm just randomly putting things in the crock pot. Before the last patch, a monster meat and two cooked morsels and a stick yielded a kebab, so we'll see if that still works. But yeah, there is definitely a fine line. You have to be somewhat linear, but have freedom of choice as well. Yeah, I don't know where that fine line is for me. I think I would prefer it to be more freedom-based. Because even if I'm lost, I can still kind of figure out where to go and what to do and have fun. But if
as far as JRPGs go, I agree. Like, because 11 just not 11, 13, just was like, what is this? Like, there's you're supposed to be able to explore.
Yeah, no, yeah. I agree with that. It feels like RPGs for beginners when they don't let you explore on your own. It's like Mystic Quest. Like, I talk about Mystic Quest a lot because people hate on it quite a bit. I don't think Mystic Quest was meant for an experienced RPG audience. It was meant for people, like, if you had never played an RPG before and you're, I don't know, like a kid, like 10 years old or something, and they hand you Mystic Quest, your average kid is going to be like, wow, I can play this game, you know, this is pretty cool, and you learn how to play RPGs.
Dude. Yes, but it was, Final Fantasy 13 was like an advanced version of Mystic Quest.
Yeah, I mean, it was so linear. I remember being completely disappointed when we had that game as kids because was so easy and you had zero freedom. I remember having no freedom at all. It just was like this map that reminded me of Super Mario Brothers or like Super Mario World where you just kind of like go to the next area and go in and then you complete that area, go to the next area. It was really, really simple and terrible at the same time, but I don't think it was meant for me. That's why when I think about it later, I'm like, it teaches you how to play RPGs if you don't know what you're doing. So maybe I'm a little more forgiving about it now than I was then, but I was very disappointed by it when I was a kid. You can't jump in Final Fantasy 13. You can jump in Mystic Quest.
Yeah, oh, that's right.
Final Fantasy 13, less advanced than Mystic Quest, a game that was, what, out 15, 20 years ago? Something like that? I mean, it's been forever. The game is old, old. It's ridiculous. Well, what can you do? You know, I guess some people like their games linear. I just don't know why they would do that now. Like, and 13 doesn't feel like it's meant for kids. You know, it doesn't feel like it's meant to train people how to play RPGs either, You really have to wonder. So you can't cook jerky. I guess that makes sense. Put this ring thing away. I don't know what the hell it is. I probably don't need it for anything, but putting it away. And I need to see about making a speedy farm plot. Let's see. Some more wood. Okay. What else do I have that I can put away? I don't need this right now. I have extra stone. I'll just take the bulk with me. Leave the gold here as well. I don't know what the hell to do with this eye bone. I'm going to put the eye bone on the ground because maybe Chester will show yourself. That's not good. That sounds like it might be hound's time. I'm ready, just in case. It's day 13. It could be hound's time. Eye bone is creepy. I'm going to leave it there. Yeah, I think she's getting ready for hounds. How do you unlock all this stuff? You mean like the characters? Well, Joker, what you do is you play the game and you get as far as you can and then die. And when you die, your XP starts ticking up. And the more XP you have, you'll unlock the characters as you go. But you basically need to die with your characters to unlock more. So that's how it works. They actually reward you for getting yourself killed by unlocking the characters. And Wilson's a pretty good character to start. If you haven't unlocked anything yet, he has the meat effigy, which you can actually give yourself an extra life. So definitely don't feel bad about dying for a very long time, if ever, in this game, because that's what it's about, unlocking the characters and dying at first. And yeah, you're right about Saga Frontier, Ethan. I think I would probably appreciate it more now as well, you know, and I liked it back then, but I still don't know how far I would get in it. Like, I don't think I beat it either. I'm trying to remember. I don't think I beat it. And beating a game is not necessary for me to actually enjoy a game. It's not necessary. Let's see, can I put these in here? I can. Let's put some berries, three berries, and a meat morsel. Let's see what that makes. It's gonna make horrible mush. Horrible, untasty mush goo. I guess I should make some more kebabs.
Mush goo?
Mush goo, yeah. It's a technical term. But I actually liked, it was very rewarding in Saga Frontier when I would find something and actually progress on one of the characters' stories because it was so ridiculously hard. You had to go to every single town and talk to all the NPCs again. It was pretty much like every time you were on each step of the quest, you would get like a line of dialogue, you would get no hints, and then eventually you would get something else that would happen. You're like, oh my god, I talked to the right person, and now more stuff. Very small rewards, but it was very gradual and cool. Yeah, I had to reinstall it too, Joker. The patch apparently is giving some people trouble on Steam. I had to completely uninstall it and reinstall again. Whoops, it's dark. I need to get out of my camp because I'm getting ready to set a fire. I went to put my my charcoal on and dropped it. Oh god. Go. Let's add some fuel. In fact, I need to add a little bit more. Let's add some pine cones. Yeah, I guess it's bugged. The Don't Starve patch that came out about a day and a half ago. Usually they release their patches pretty late in the day. So it's been, it was either yesterday or the day before, I can't remember now. You remember getting to the final boss in the mutant character story, but never beat it.
What mutant character are we talking about?
In Saga Frontier.
Oh, okay.
Saga Frontier had some really cool characters. Like, all of them had very detailed stories, you know, for being a PlayStation 1 game, I guess. It was just really, I don't know, there was something really cool about it, just because it was so hard, and, like, learning all the stuff about the characters just felt super rewarding, because it was a lot of work. I don't know if I would play a game like that now. I don't know. I might get too frustrated at this point, now that there's other things that can occupy my attention. I mean, I play a lot of games like Don't Starve. These things are just, it's like this random game. What is this? Meatballs. Okay, that combination made meatballs. I think I'm gonna go back to making kebabs. Since I already have a stack, let's do that. And I need to... Wait, let's see if the drying rack is done. Harvest drying rack it is. Yeah, the small jerky lasts a long time.
Does it really?
Look at the, I'll put my mouse over here.
Huh.
I've had these forever, and look how much it's worn down.
Nice.
My meatballs are more worn out, but I guess that's because some of my berries were old. Saga Frontier was the same universe as Final Fantasy Legends. Oh yeah, Final Fantasy Legends.
Is that the very first Final Fantasy on the Game Boy?
Yes, that's what I was thinking, is that it was Game Boy
the one
Legends.
Where your monster dudes could eat the meat and change?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes sense, because they had mutants in that game. That's the one that they could change.
Were they called mutants? Because they were psionics.
They were different. There were mutants you could have, and then monsters. Oh, monsters were the ones that could change by eating the meat.
Because the mutants had psionics or something like that, right?
It was almost like, it was like Pokemon for Final Fantasy, in a way. So, adventure game mode is actually kind of a quest-driven way to play Don't Starve. I haven't tried it yet, because I'm hearing that it's not quite finished yet. You can certainly try to test it, but I think people have been having some trouble with it. Like, it's not done in Don't Starve. So, depending on how patient you are, you can always give it a shot and see if it's fun. I just play Sandbox for now. And I don't know if they've actually made any improvements to the adventure mode in this patch. They might have, so up to you whether or not you give it a try, Joker. Yeah, the monster character, you're right, Ethan. They're the ones that ate the meat and changed. I do remember the mutants, vaguely. It's just been so long since I played those games. And then they came out with... It was Final Fantasy Adventure on Game Boy. I remember that one. It was kind of a Zelda-like game. Oh, I don't have any more flowers for a hat. Even I don't know everything yet. My character admits to not knowing things. Let's make a straw hat. Why not? Let's see, we're gonna have to cook some more stuff. Monster meat. Two morsels. And a stick. I'm gonna have to go out and get some more fuel. The good news is, I'm right next to all my charcoal, so I might do that. I also need some more wood, because I was gonna build Just gonna build something with wood. Oh, a farm plot, that's right. Let's see, I probably should use these berries before I go, too. Yeah, if you try adventure mode, Joker, you'll have to let me know how it is, because I have not tried it yet. Just kind of avoiding it for now. No real reason, other than it's not quite done, and I don't really feel like beta testing that part of the game, so I haven't been. Just more kebabs. Excellent. Alright, let's put these. Let's see if I put two berries and two morsels in. What happens? Should be meatballs again, but alright. Let's go over here and see if I can get my charcoal gathered up a little bit. It's getting ready to get a little dark. So I know I have a bunch of burned trees here still. Here we go. I have to avoid the trees over there in the southeast because there's a forest spirit there. I managed to get to go back to sleep right away. Planting trees makes them go to sleep. At some point though, I might end up killing him. Because he drops an item I might need. I don't need it right now. I'm just going for survivability at the moment. What is this? Night is coming. But I do need some more wood. So now I'm going to get some. I see you, spider. Nice. Away with you. I don't want to kill any spiders right now. Although, this nest over here, I'm going to have to burn this thing probably because otherwise I'm going to have a huge queen spider next to my camp.
Yeah. You don't want a spider queen. They're not extremely friendly.
No. They're not friendly at all. Yeah, this game, it's kind of an extremes, Ethan, actually. It's yes. It's extremely relaxing and then
and
something
extremely
stressful, yes. Because you'll just be like, here I am, chopping some trees and, you know, gathering a bunch of crap to see how long you can survive. And then monsters
Panic.
Run directly towards you.
Panic!
Oh, I have to eat. I guess I should eat this meatballs. What else do I have? Let's see, some berries.